Midwest, in some places 18 to 19%. I don't think we'll get there. And I think the reason why is because we do have a healthy climate for our small businesses to thrive as well. And if we could just produce a few more science and math and engineering talents coming out of our schools, we would have no competition from any other city in the nation.
You're absolutely right. That could be a competitive advantage of ours. And again, as strong as we are, if we can do that, and again, every city's having some challenges with
yes.
the public school systems. If we can all of a sudden change that so that we're getting it right, that becomes an enormous advantage to us as we attract companies and attract individuals.
Yes, that's true. That's very true. I know that we have some drug challenges, and I think much of that will change when we get more security on the border. And hopefully that will come. I think we've had to deal with the cheese factor,
mm-hmm.
But we saw all levels come together, schools, city, county, our law enforcement right. officials, all coming together to give that attention to try to see if we could get that stopped before mm-hmm. it really got good and started. And I think that we've done pretty well there.
I think we made some good inroads, and it all goes back to what you talked about a little earlier, education. If mm-hmm. if we can get more of our kids through the public school system, give them a chance to succeed either through education or trade schools
mm-hmm.
or whatever it may be, then all of a sudden a lot of the challenges that we talk about today, education is really the long-term solution.
That is very true.
A lot of things begin and end with education.
Mm-hmm. And we have some great educational opportunities in our area with the New North Texas, the University of Dallas, the University of Texas at Dallas, University of Texas at Arlington.
Yes.
And SMU, we have a great variety of opportunities there. And I always tell our young people, if you get admitted to a college, we will find some way for you to pay that
Absolutely.
Bill. And it's more expensive now, but there are scholarships mm-hmm. out there.
One of the things that we've done is set up, and again, the city and the school district are separate, but what we've tried to do is create some programs that will support what's happening in the public school system.
Mm-hmm.
One of those is a scholarship program, and we've done it with private funds, but it's a little bit different too.
Mm-hmm.
What we've tried to do is instead of traditionally the scholarship goes to the senior who's getting ready to go to college, we're now setting it fund up so we'll give it to freshmen and sophomore so that a lot of kids in some of the tougher neighborhoods, they'll know that if they stick through it, they
mm-hmm.
do a good job during that time in high school, that there's going to be a commitment. Somebody's going to be standing behind them then to provide the resources that they need to go on to college.
Yes.
And then we've also tried to almost bookend that with another program at the City of Dallas, which is an early reading program. We've
oh,
seen,
yes.
as you well know, walking through a lot of neighborhoods, we have a lot of kids that literally will walk into the first day of public school and they haven't had any exposure mm-hmm. to reading. What we've done in the City of Dallas is create an early reading program, largely leveraging it off of our libraries and librarians.
Mm-hmm.
We've already paid for them, so the cost isn't zero, but it's
yes.
it's awfully low because we've already had those assets in place. And what we're doing is taking young kids and just exposing them to reading, not physics
yes.
and brain science,
mm-hmm.
that, but just give them an exposure to know what a sentence is, what a letter is. And we think that we're going to touch about 10,000 kids a year being able to do that, so that when that child walks into the first day
mm-hmm.
at the Dallas Independent School District, that they're going to have a much better chance to succeed. And we've already
mm-hmm.
we've also worked with the school district in trying to put other programs in place, like trying to make the physical facilities
mm-hmm.
look nicer and bring some private funds into that.
Well, you've been involved in that a long time. Before you became mayor, you were working with public education.
Education is, you know, I take it personally because I wouldn't be sitting here with you if I hadn't been very fortunate to get an education when I was younger and come from a background where that wasn't a given. And I was
mm-hmm.
very fortunate. I had some people that, some from the Lord up above and some people that mentored me that got me a good education. And I know how important it is from a personal
mm-hmm.
standpoint. And then either sitting as a business leader or where I am now as mayor of one of the largest cities in the nation, I see how important that education is. And we just got to get it right.
That's mm-hmm. right. Well, it is important. As a matter of fact, when you have just a general citizenry that is well educated, you have a better environment in your city. And certainly opportunities are greater. For every, 90% of our dropouts end up in prison.
Yeah.
So we know the value of of education for everyone. It doesn't, like you say, it doesn't have to be a college education, but there are other skills that can learn. And we're losing some of those older skills like shoe repair and watch repair. And I'm hoping that we'll see some of those come back because technology hadn't taken over all of that.
No, it hasn't. But one of the challenges that we have, too, that people I don't think realize is, you know, in the economy of 30 or 40 years ago, we could take about 30 or 40% of the kids and they didn't need an education. We had a lot of manufacturing mm-hmm. type of jobs and that sort of thing that didn't necessarily require a higher education, but they had good benefits with them. Mm-hmm. They had retirements, those sorts mm-hmm. of things. Well, now that we've seen our economy shift from a manufacturing to more service-oriented, more of a knowledge base, a lot of those jobs don't exist. So not only do we have the challenges in education, the bar has been set higher than it was
yes.
previously.
Yes.
So it means that, again, we've got to work that much harder.
That's right. And I'm hoping that our young people will hang in there and stay with it, because the more education you have, really the happier you're going to be as you move through life, because your opportunities will be greater. And so, well, let me thank you so much for taking the time to come. I know you're on a tight schedule, and I don't want to keep you too long, but I'm so delighted to have the opportunity.
Well, Congressman, again, I want to reinforce how appreciative, not only in the city of Dallas from a government standpoint, but all the citizens of Dallas, because I can tell you, working closely with you the last 2 years, I've seen your work, your love, your compassion for Dallas, and how that's been reflected in projects like the Trinity River Corridor Project and so many others, your commitment to investments like a convention center hotel, really looking at the future and saying, mm-hmm. we want to make sure that tomorrow is even brighter than it is today in Dallas. And I just want you to know how appreciative we are of you.
Well, thank you. I know this, that my opportunities came from people who looked forward to the future to make sure they were there. And I feel very strongly that I should be doing whatever it takes to leave opportunities for others. And we have a beautiful city. We're trying to make it even more beautiful, but also to make it a better place to live. We've done a lot in our environmental. We've cleaned up these brownfields. When I passed the American Center and realized that was a brownfield,
yes.
and how beautiful it is now, that it makes me know that there is great potential still left.
Like the Convention Center Hotel, we took a risk on that, and look at the benefit we've got. We've got the arena, all the development that's come around mm-hmm. it. We've got an area that everybody in the world looks at now and is an attractive area. And that's the same sort of decision mm-hmm. we have to make. And on environmental, I'm happy to look at anybody now. As I was in your committee hearing this morning, the subcommittee that you chair, I was happy to say that Dallas is really at the forefront by green building, purchasing renewable energy, alternative fleets, what we're doing in so many different areas. And again,
yes.
we appreciate your leadership in those areas.
Well, thank you so very much. And thank you for watching. And we'll see you next week.
This has been another edition of Report from Washington featuring Congresswoman Eddie Bernice Johnson. You can reach Congresswoman Johnson at 202-225-8885 or 214-922-8885. You can also contact her through her website at http://www.house.gov/ebjohnson.